Let's be honest, working with Tumbler mockups can be a bit of a hassle. You think you've found the perfect template with three different views, but then you realize each view has its own smart object. Suddenly, a simple task turns into hours of repetitive edits. Sound familiar? Well, there's a smarter way to do this, and I'm about to show you how. The real frustration comes down to those three separate smart objects, one for each view. Every time you want to update a design, you're stuck repeating the same process three times. It's tedious, right? And if you're working on multiple designs or large batches, it becomes a serious time drain. But here's the good news. There's a much simpler way to handle this. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to streamline your workflow by creating one smart object that updates all three views at once. No more repetitive edits or wasted time, just a smooth, efficient process. Let's break it down into 9 simple steps. Step 1, get the design file dimensions. The first thing you'll need to do is determine the dimensions of your design file. Watch closely as I walk you through this. If you're on a Mac, start by selecting the image you're working with. Right-click on the image and select Get Info. See how the info window pops up? There it is, the dimensions of your image clearly listed. Make sure to jot these numbers down because they're key for setting up your mockup. Now, if you're using Windows, the process is just as easy. Find your image, right-click on it, and select Properties. You'll see that a window appears with different tabs. Click on the Details tab, take a look. You'll find all the detailed information about your image, including its dimensions. Write those down as well. These numbers are what we use to set up the smart object, and they're key to making the design look flawless when applied to the Tumbler. Step 2, save and load selections. Before we jump into creating the smart object, let's take a minute to talk about saving selections. This step is super helpful for keeping everything accurate and making the process much smoother later on. First, open the Tumbler mockup template. Once it's loaded, create a new layer. Next, select the Quick Selection tool and enable the Sample All Layers option from the top menu. Now select the first Tumbler with the help of Quick Selection tool, holding down the Alt key to remove any unwanted areas from your selection. Alternatively, you can use the Pen tool to precisely outline each Tumbler view for more accuracy. Once that's done, head up to the menu bar, click on Select, and then choose Save Selection. A box will pop up where you can give your selection a name. Make it something simple and clear, like Tumbler View 1 or Zone 1, so you'll know exactly what it is when you need it again. Now, to load a selection you've saved, just go back to the menu, click on Select, and choose Load Selection. Pick the name you saved earlier, and your selection will pop right back into place. See how easy that is? You won't need to redraw anything, and it's ready to go whenever you need it. Repeat this process for Tumbler 2 and 3 and save the selections. Saving these selections now is a total time saver, and trust me, you'll appreciate it when you're deep into the workflow and everything's running smoothly. Step 3, create the smart object. Now it's time to create a smart object. Select the rectangle tool and click on the canvas region. In the rectangle dialog window, set the width to 3,732 pixels and the height to 2,739 pixels. These are the exact dimensions we measured earlier, ensuring everything fits perfectly. Hit enter. Do not worry if the rectangle goes beyond the canvas area. Next, right-click on the rectangle layer in your layers panel and choose Convert to Smart Object. Now press Ctrl plus T to activate the Transform tool and scale back the smart object layer to fit within the canvas. This turns the rectangle into a flexible, editable base layer for all three Tumbler views. From here, the process becomes much simpler since you can update the design easily without starting over. This step sets everything up nicely for what's coming next. Step 4, create the surface. Before we get into this step, let's recall something about the Tumbler. It has three distinct faces, each representing a different viewing angle. Now, to handle these views, we'll divide the design into three zones. Each zone will be further split into two sections, giving us a total of 6 sections, each represented by a different color. This setup ensures precise alignment and easy organization as we move forward. To create an equal layout, double-click the Smart Object icon to open it, then navigate to the View menu and hover over Guides. From there, choose New Guide Layout. In the pop-up menu, go to the Row section and uncheck the box to disable rows, then move to the Column section and set it to 6. This will divide the layout into 6 equal segments. At this stage, there's no need to manually add guides. Using this new guide layout, we have a clear structure with 6 guides, making it easy to add colors and labels. Now that we already have 6 equal sections as guide, we will select either the Marquee Selection tool or the Rectangle tool and use it to create a rectangle spanning 2 sections. Once the selection is made, adjust the color of this section by going to the Properties panel and selecting a new color. Next, use the Rectangle tool again to create a second section. Adjust the color of this section by going to the Properties panel and selecting a new color. Then, use the Rectangle tool a third time to create another selection, completing 3 distinct sections, each with its own color. To add more sections, select the Marquee Selection tool and make a selection of 1 part. Create a new layer, then right-click on the selected area to access the fill options. Choose a color and adjust the shade to make it slightly darker for contrast. For the smaller sections, use the guides to ensure a perfect selection. You can either add these to the same layer or create a new layer. Right-click again to fill the area, choosing a color and darkening it slightly for variety. For better organization, keep in mind to assign a unique color to each section and label them with easy-to-remember names or numbers. When you're done, save your changes by pressing Ctrl plus S and close the Smart Object with Ctrl plus W. You might be thinking, why do we need to go through the trouble of splitting it into zones? Well, dividing the surface into zones not only sets our work for the next steps, but also makes the entire alignment process smoother and more intuitive. This is because when each zone is clearly defined and color-coded, placing your design elements becomes a simple and hassle-free task. Step 5, duplicate the smart object, Control plus J. All right, here's where things get really handy. You're going to duplicate the smart object by pressing Control plus J. Now here's the cool part. When you duplicate a smart object, all the copies are linked. That means if you make a change to one, whether it's adding a new image, adjusting the colors, or moving something around, that same change will automatically show up in all the other copies. This is a total lifesaver, especially if you're working on a Tumbler design with multiple views. Instead of having to update each section individually, you just make the adjustment once and it will be reflected everywhere. It keeps everything consistent and saves you a ton of time. Honestly, once you start using this, you'll wonder how you ever worked without it. Step 6, position the holder. In positioning the smart object, we'll start by pressing Command plus R on Mac or Control plus R on Windows to activate the ruler. Once the ruler is visible, we'll drag and place the guides at crucial points on the tumbler. Starting with the first tumbler, we'll place the first guide at its starting edge. Next, we'll add a second guide at the center of the first tumbler to maintain symmetry, followed by a third guide at its end edge, marking where this section of the design will stop. We'll then repeat the same process for the second tumbler. One guide at the start, one at the center, and one at the end. Finally, we'll do the same for the third tumbler, ensuring each section is evenly divided and aligned properly. Once the vertical guides are in place, we need to add horizontal guides to mark important points on the tumbler's surface. The first horizontal guide will be positioned at the top brim of the tumbler. Then we'll add 2 more horizontal guides, one where the curvature of the tumbler begins and another where it ends. These guides will help ensure that the design follows the natural shape of the tumbler without distortion. These guides are essential reference points and will come in handy when wrapping the design. With the guide set, we can now adjust the smart object. First, make the Zone 1 layer visible by clicking the eye icon in the Layers panel and reduce its opacity to 50%. Using the center vertical guides as a reference, align the smart object carefully so that each section sits perfectly within its designated tumbler. Repeat this process for each zone. make final adjustments to ensure everything is positioned correctly. Proper alignment at this stage is crucial for a seamless and professional looking result. Step 7, add control points and warp. All right, now that the smart object is in position, it's time to shape the design so it wraps perfectly around the tumbler. We'll do this using the warp tool, which lets us bend and adjust the design to follow the tumbler's natural curve. Before we start warping the smart object, we need to lock the guides to prevent them from accidentally moving during the transformation process. To do this, navigate to the top menu bar, click on View, then hover over Guides, and finally select Lock Guides. This will ensure that the guides stay in place and won't interfere while adjusting the smart object. Now, select Zone 1 and press Control plus T or Command plus T on Mac to bring up the transform controls. Right-click anywhere inside the bounding box, and from the drop-down menu, choose Warp. You'll notice a grid overlay on your design. This is where we'll start working our magic. To make the adjustments precise, we need to add control points at key locations where we previously placed guides, especially where the zones meet. Hold down Control or Command on Mac and click on the warp grid at these critical points to create control points. Start by adding a point at the tumbler's center where we already placed a guide, then place another point at the tumbler's end edge. Next, add points at the curvature areas where the tumbler starts and finishes curving. These control points allow you to push and pull specific parts of the design, giving you total control over how it curves. Take your time here, adjust the points gently, making sure the design flows smoothly and wraps naturally around the tumbler's shape. It might take a bit of trial and error, but it's worth it to get a seamless look. After perfectly warping Zone 1, hide this layer by clicking on the eye icon in the Layers panel. Now, make Zone 2 visible by clicking on its eye icon and follow the same warping process. Press Control plus T to bring up the transform controls. Right-click to select Warp, and then add control points at the same guide positions, center, edges, and curvature points. Use the guides as a reference to ensure a smooth and accurate wrap. Once Zone 2 is perfectly aligned, hide it and move on to Zone 3. Make it visible and repeat the exact same steps, ensuring each section aligns seamlessly with the tumbler shape. Once you're happy with how the design aligns, you can clean up the view by turning off the guides. Go to the top menu, click on View, then hover over Show, and uncheck Guides to remove the visual clutter. This step is what really brings the mock-up to life. Warping the design ensures it hugs the tumbler perfectly, making the final product look polished, professional, and ready to show off. Step 8, finalize with masking. Now let's refine the design by applying masks to isolate specific sections. Start by reloading your saved selections. Select Zone 1 layer, go to the menu, click on Select, then choose Load Selection from the dropdown. From the list, select the saved area that matches the zone you're working on. Once the selection is active, apply it as a mask to the smart object layer. This step hides the unnecessary parts of the design and keeps only the relevant sections visible. Masks make it easy to focus on each part without affecting the rest. Step 9, repeat and finalize. Once you've masked the first section, move on to the next. Reload the corresponding save selection, apply the mask, and make any necessary opacity adjustments. Repeat this process for each zone, ensuring each section aligns perfectly. At the end of this step, all parts of your tumbler design will be neatly divided and properly masked, ready for the final touch. Now that you've gone through the steps, you can see how this process simplifies your workflow. No more wasting time on repetitive edits or juggling multiple smart object layers. With this streamlined approach, everything stays consistent and easy to manage. This method not only saves you time, but also ensures you produce polished, professional Tumbler mockups that truly stand out. What if you're looking for an even easier and faster way to achieve the same results? That's where the Bulk Mockup plugin comes in. It takes all the hard work out of the equation, letting you create multiple mockups with just a few clicks. See how much easier that makes everything? Gone are the days of juggling multiple smart object layers or spending hours on repetitive tasks. Whether you're creating mockups for your Etsy shop, a client project, or just for fun, this trick will save you time and help you achieve clean, professional results every time. Give it a try and let me know how it works out for you. If you have any questions or tips of your own, drop them in the comments. I'd love to hear from you. See ya in the next video. And don't forget, we'll be diving into more tutorials using the Bulk Mockup plugin to help you take your designs to the next level. Stay tuned because we'll show you how to supercharge your workflow with this powerful tool.